Premier Cape Coral News team, bald eagles could soon become even more vulnerable in the city. The Cape wants to roll back some protections the birds have to let builders get a little bit closer. NBC2's Jesse Pankin is live with why some wildlife advocates say this is a wrong turn. Jesse.
Now, Rachel, mainly the city wants to reduce the buffer zone surrounding active nests within the city. Now, they want to hear from people what they have to think about this here in the city, and a lot of people here say that that could end up being a mistake.
It's just amazing every time I see them. Just amazing.
Sarah Cushman says she got lucky when she caught sight of a bald eagle closer than ever before.
I walked about halfway up the side of the fence and just zoomed in on him, and he watched me, I watched him.
A once-in-a-lifetime experience she and others worry could go extinct if the Cape rolls back protection in the city.
We are asking to change this ordinance for the very few people that it affects.
The city could soon reduce the size of the 1,100-foot buffer zones around active nests to help with development nearby and line up the city's law with the state's. However, wildlife advocates say the rules are stricter in the Cape for a reason.
If they don't have a place to live and a food supply, they will leave.
On top of that, Pasha Donaldson says the eagles are a moneymaker for the Cape.
Ecotourism is dollars for Cape Coral. They stay at hotels, the people. They shop at our stores. They eat at our restaurants. They pay for gasoline.
While others hope they just stick around the Cape and aren't driven out.
We keep building close to them. We're going to start driving them away. And people are going to have to start seeing them in zoos and rehabilitation facilities.
Now, the changes would also mean that anyone building anything bigger than a home or a duplex near an eagle's nest would have to submit what's called an eagle nest management plan, basically laying out how they would protect the nest while building. Now, council's going to be talking about all of this at their public hearing on Monday. We're live in Cape Coral this morning. I'm Jesse Pagan, NBC2.